Economics, Bitcoin, February 12, 2018, 6:33 p.m. Greenwich Mean Time by EconMatters Bitcoin had rocketed from $900 to almost $20,000 in 2017. We discussed why Bitcoin is a really bad investment for any investors and how 20% of Bitcoin owners took out debt in this get-rich-quick gamble. It could all work out for everyone involved if Bitcoin were to continue its run towards $25,000 or even $60,000, according to some overly zealous predictions. The problem is Bitcoin has crashed to around $8,600 as I write this post today. Central banks like PBOC are moving to tighten oversight of Bitcoin exchanges. Banks have banned purchasing Bitcoins using their credit cards. Yet another news tells a different side but equally disturbing story. It turns out instead of racking up debt to finance a Bitcoin investment, others invested in lenders, which accept real money for interest, paid out in fringe cryptocurrencies, quite a few coin. Companies have done aggressive marketing campaigns with ads and newsletters. For example, one such ad says, "Turn a single $100 bill into a retirement fortune in a matter of months." A cryptocurrency company, Devourcoin, reportedly promised users on Jan 31, "Lend us your money and you'll have the chance to win $1 million. All Devourcoin users had to do was loan Devourcoin their money. At the minimum, Devour promised huge returns on the loans, in the form of the company's own kind of cryptocurrency DAV, not to mention there's chance to win the $1 million jackpot. Another company, BitConnect, one of the largest crypto lending companies, promised an impossible 1% daily return on investment. Then there are also companies advertise cryptocurrency-based title loans for cars. Does that sound just a tad like a Ponzi scheme, but not to the cryptocurrency faithful crowd? One study suggests that buyers of Bitcoin, a cryptocurrency, are comfortable with a loan scheme in exchange for the digital money, which they believe will soar in value. Devourcoin's DAV plunged from $180 to less than 1 cent per coin right now. That means the lenders in the real money for DAV loan scheme are now left with pennies on the dollar, based on Facebook posts. One user said he loaned Devour $4,000 and was left holding $9. Another said his $20,000 loan to Devourcoin yielded the equivalent of $23.50 when he tried to cash out. The good news is that BitConnect and Devourcoin have both been served with cease and desist letters from the Texas State Securities Board this year. BitConnect is completely shut down while Devour has shut down its loan platform, but apparently DAV is still listed on separate coin exchange platform. The bad news is that two scams down and many more are eager to take their places. Type in cryptocurrency lending company in Google search, and you will see what I mean. One such platform even boasts, these BitConnect clones can help you make easy regular money like clockwork. You get paid on a daily basis anywhere from 3% to 20%, judging from the recent act by the Trump administration to drop a lawsuit into a lender alleged to charge up to 950% interest. Investors and consumers are left to their own devices, not getting sucked into one Ponzi scheme after another. By EconMatters, http://www.econmatters.com/ The theory of quantum mechanics and Einstein's theory of relativity, E equals mc2, have taught us that matter, yin, and energy, yang, are interrelated and interdependent. This interconnectedness of all things is the essence of the concept, yin-yang, and Einstein's fundamental equation, matter equals energy. The same theories may be applied to equities and commodity markets. All things within the markets and macroeconomy undergo constant change and transformation, and everything is interconnected. That's why here at Economic Forecasts, that's why, with a team of analysts, we at EconMatters focus on identifying the fundamental theories of cause and effect in the financial markets that matters to your portfolio. Copyright 2018, copyright EconMatters, all rights reserved. Disclaimer: the above is a matter of opinion provided for general information purposes only and is not intended as investment advice. Information and analysis above are derived from sources and utilizing methods believed to be reliable, but we cannot accept responsibility for any losses you may incur as a result of this analysis. Individuals should consult with their personal financial advisors. Copyright 2005 to 2018. http://www.marketoracle.co.uk. The Market Oracle is a free daily financial markets analysis. Only logged in users are allowed to post comments. Register, login.